People view every.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog basketball. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking thick hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. I had to get you touch, and it get you foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of boy. They always screaming, reach me snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof in the stain. Please don't test me like on that boy Johnny. And ain't talking dang. It's like everything look cut them jaw.
Today, from Soldier Field in Chicago, it's week 9 of the NFL on EA Sports. Chicago Bears taking on the Detroit Lions.
The
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to one of our favorite spots, Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel, ready for football are they, and ready for football are we, as the Bears get set to match up with the Detroit Lions. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. They have certainly got it rolling of late. Winners of six in a row.
And it's simple. The more you win in the regular season, the more likely you play at home in the postseason. And that can take you deep into January.
The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week nine? And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. And out will come the leader of this offense. And that, of course, is their signal caller.
I guess we have to nickname him the thrower, aren't we, or something
after
like that.
After last week?
I mean, man, you're talking about over 400 yards throwing the ball. The running backs and everyone else may be looking at him like, hey, don't forget us. And he probably just tell him, listen, you want to get involved?
Go out.
Go out and catch some passes. I'll make sure you touch it.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First carry for DeAndre Swift. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. They'll drop to throw. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll try and run here with Swift. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. They're going to try and throw. That's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And he gets this to the other side of midfield, across the 45 before going out. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth.
Mission accomplished on that throw. Slant, pick up the first down. I like how he just put it on the receiver and didn't lead him on that one.
Happened quickly. Defense, not much they could do. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 44-yard line. They'll look to throw here. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. This crowd does not like that call.
Understandable reaction from them. That's their team that the penalty's going against. But you and I both know they're going to take care of the quarterback.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Throw right side complete to Williams. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Let's go. Back to 60. On second down, Swift. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of four. But you and I, partner, we got the plum assignment this week. An unbeaten team against a one-loss team. Really not much separating these two entering play here today.
Not much at all. And I think for both coaches, they've looked at their team and said, guys, you got to know what you're getting into in this one. And you better be ready to go, because you get to answer the big question of the day. Are we as good as we think we are? We're about to find out.
Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. A
first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams. And the nimble footwork gets him just inside the 10 to the 9, but no further. And now we're going to get a stoppage as, yeah, that looks like Jackson who's shaken up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Three yards remain for second down. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just threw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Flushed out right. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for six and a first down.
Now that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the five-yard line.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Swift, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead.
First quarter, maybe too early to talk about statement drives, Charles, but that sure seemed like a statement drive right there.
Well, if we're going to talk about statement drives, I think what they're saying is we're going to establish the run. They gave it to him early and often on this drive, and he wound up taking it into the end zone.
Crew able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. So here now the Bears offense for their first drive of the game. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
And I thought it was a really nice performance last week by him. Three touchdown passes. I think that signifies exactly what he was getting. One interception.
But that's the ratio you said. First and 10, here's Fields. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Levi Onwuzurike, able to collapse the pocket, get to him, and drop him for a loss of a yard.
And they get to him right out of the gate. And this defense hoping that that's a harbinger of things to come.
Yeah, when you give up a first place sack, makes your quarterback wonder if he's going to go to the sidelines and talk with his offense coordinator and head coach and say, hey, you know that game plan we put together? We might need to change it right now.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Another try after the first down sack. Fields. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Now Fields. Into the secondary, past the 40. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field. Right in there.
Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. So now make that a second sack for them on this drive.
And Brandon, we hear it every week when we go out to do a game. Everyone talks about playing complimentary football. Their offense goes down and scores. They see that, and they want to back them up, and that they did, getting two sacks on this first drive.
Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Now this defense for the Lions, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get
turnovers. Now, loose football. The ball comes out. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And we're in the middle part of the season where each week starts to become a little more important, and especially this, Charles, being a division matchup.
Yeah, you haven't fired the starter's pistol or rang the bell lap like they do in track and field for the sprint to the finish, but you're starting to eye it, aren't you? You got to pile up those wins, put them in the left-hand column, not the L's in the right-hand column.
And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. He's going to sling this deep downfield. A contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. And he takes this thing way down into Chicago territory. One of the good things about throwing in his direction, he usually has the size advantage on those two-man catches.
And what I like about his game is that he carries himself at his full height. He understands it's an advantage and uses it at every opportunity.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They'll look to throw. And he's got it. And in for the Lions touchdown. A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0 the score as they regroup with first and 10. action. It's Fields.
That ball complete to Isabella. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. From the gun, here's Fields. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. To throw is Fields. And Fields going to have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give him seven there on the first down carry.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And that is incomplete here. And, Charles, you think about what this defense has had to prepare for. They're in for a battle. I mean, they're facing a team that is working on a six-game winning streak.
And that can be intimidating when you think about it in those terms, but I think what they need to do is make some sort of a statement early in this game, whether it's a turnover, a takeaway, a key sack on third down, a three and out. Something lets the other guys know that you mean business. Figuratively, throw the first punch and make it a good one.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back to throw, Fields. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Fields. Dancing. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top two teams right now in that division.
And if you can build a bit of a cushion as you head towards the second part of the season, that allows you to survive the expected injuries, potential upset losses, all of those things, and still be in good shape.
2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. They'll set up to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over first and 10.
Another drive coming up for this Chicago offense.
And so close to hitting pay dirt last time. Fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we'll put some points up and have a little momentum going. They got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go,
short-term memory,
and move on to the next series.
On second and 10, Fields. This one caught by Isabella. And he's taken down inside the 30. A Chicago first down there on a gain of 11.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they're having panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
A gain of 6 there on first.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
To the air again, Fields. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Here's Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. The Bears tried it on fourth down, unable to convert. And the Lions will take over. A chance to get some momentum here in the second quarter, getting their first trip into the red zone, but unable to get it across.
And if I'm the head coach, sure, you feel some disappointment, maybe a little bit of deflation there because you didn't get it in, but I'm going straight to rah-rah mode. All right, guys, we didn't get it this time. That's only the second quarter. We'll be back. Let's get it later on. I want to keep this team up. I want them to feel like they've let everyone down.
Positive.
Got to be positive in this situation. It's too early to think that you don't have a chance to win this game.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They're going to look to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And incomplete on the deep ball.
So, CD, you talk about this football team. Some of the whispers and reports, the social media posts, they hint at a locker room that's splintered, badly splintered. There was talk earlier, some guys might walk away entirely. But that hasn't happened, however, at least to this point.
No, and sometimes some of that talk is just that, talk. I mean, guys often say, that's it, I'm out of here. And then they realize, I'm not ready to retire yet. What am I going to do now? And they're really ready to come back and dive back in. In fact, we got guys who are wearing gold jackets in the Hall of Fame that talked about retirement the last 6-7 years of their career. So that's not always real. And sometimes you just have to go ahead and ride it out. And this is an opportunity.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
He's going to go up top again. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Here's Jack Fox now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Fair catch signal for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he's going to lose yardage, not that it matters, as the final seconds tick away.
So we have come to halftime in what's already a two-touchdown game. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, all right, Brandon. Thank you very much. Hi again, everyone. Let's get you caught up with what's going on around the NFL. We are officially into the second half of the season. We'll get started out at GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. And it's the Chiefs who have the lead in that one. The Chiefs trying to finish that one off and claim victory. From there, let's head cross-country to D.C. to check out the football team at home at FedEx Field. And you can see they trail in that matchup against the Tampa Bay Bucks. Darius Slayton, a touchdown reception. Finally, we'll save the biggest for last. We head to AT&T Stadium to see what's happening with the Cowboys at home in Arlington. And right now they have the lead over the visiting New York Giants. Two touchdown passes there for Dak Prescott. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Bears offense set to go to begin the third quarter, and right out of the gate they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
Gets by him, and now a little daylight. The 30, 10, touchdown, Chicago. Khalil Herbert, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bears come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return, here's King. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So here are the Lions to take over. They've got the lead right now, and remember, they are riding that very impressive 7-game winning streak, trying to push it to 8. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games. And we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. A first down run, good for about 3. Second and 7 coming up. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. He'll look to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Buying time to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10, right at the 40. He'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Rolling to his right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Play fake here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And that's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up in excellent shape with a first and goal.
They'll set up a throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Mike Williams, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. On second down, Herbert. And this will be a Bears first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. 89 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Fields now to throw. Rolling to his left. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's 3rd down. Now it's Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first. Fields on target to Mooney. First down, Chicago. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now it's second and 9. Here's Fields. Steps away. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. Back to throw. Fields. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They snap it to Fields. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Robinson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Fields on first down. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. And again, this time to the tailback. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
On second and 7, Fields. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Looking to throw. Fields. Touchdown, Bears! A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bears have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
Here's Gay now to add the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And the end result is a Bears touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, and he opted for the touchback. And Detroit back in possession of the football. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here, or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But I believe Elijah
Eagles there to recover it. Yes, they will indeed keep possession.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Back to throw here. Eluding the pressure right. And this one is incomplete.
Whenever you see a quarterback break contain, just think to yourself, the receivers on that side of the field, their number one job, make sure they get in his sight line so he can try and find someone downfield. Guys on the backside, make sure you don't give up the deep ball. They tried it there. They weren't able to connect.
So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Bears take over. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, then their defense forces that last punt, and now a chance to tie the game on this possession. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Back to throw. Fields. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing on third down, Fields. Able to find Isabella. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
On first down, Fields. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Out of the gun, Fields. That's complete right side to Kmet. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He'll buy some time right, and he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. He's back to throw. That's Isabella open on the right side. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. That catch good for five. It's third down. They'll look to throw. I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Here we go on fourth down, Fields. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. John Johnson with the INT, and the Lions have just about sewn up this football game. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
Hey, it's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
That one looks like he'll throw here, escaping the pressure right. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. This is a very important drive, and
and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So now Fields and the Bears down 21-14, a minute 24 to go. Their long win streak in great peril as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. The Bears moving hastily into hurry-up offense. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Mooney. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's got this down to the 35. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. That's complete to his running back, Herbert. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Back to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Again, Fields. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough. Trying to drop a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, you know, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So for the Lions, they continue to cruise as they move to 8-0 now on the campaign.
And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for Chicago, the loss will drop them to 6-2 now on the year. And they will be at home next week to take on the New York Giants. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
for more.
You fired up, I'm fired up. Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3. Hey.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel an envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The